hundreds of them. 6 o'clock.
It's got German markings.
Let's get them.
Where are the damn fighters going?
Is there anything left of our escort?
Mayday! Mayday! Prepare to bail out!
Our boys are getting cut to shreds.
I need pilots who will put the bombers ahead of themselves.
4 o'clock.
Stay with the bombers.
When we came under your command, Colonel, you stated very clearly that we would never find Negroes who could pass a pilot's exam, make it through flight school, survive basic combat. We've done all of that.
I don't believe your boys have scored a single aerial kill.
It's damn hard to shoot down the enemy 100 miles behind the front lines.
What we do, how well we do it, does it matter?
And you all thought what?
You'd sign up, and that'd be the end of 100 years of bigotry. Get your head up, son. You're fighter pilots.
We have a right to fight for our country, the same as every other American. We will not go away.
I can't afford the kind of losses my bombers have been suffering. Can you help save lives?
If you get us new planes, we can help your boys.
Nothing's difficult.
Everything's a challenge.
Through adversity to the stars.
From the last plane, to the last bullet, to the last minute, to the last man, we fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
At all costs, we protect the heavies.
Easy, I see something. It's a train, 11 o'clock.
Let's go get it.
Wait, easy, easy. We gotta take it head on. Low, so their guns can't hit us.
It's my decision, Lightning. Stay in formation.
That's 10 men. We count our victories by the bombers we get to their targets. By the husbands we return to their wives. By the fathers we get back to their children.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Junior, bail!
Welcome back. Now we're going to talk about Red Tails. And this is a story about the
Tuskegee Airmen. And it's very historical because it's a true story. And it tells about how in World War II, the black the men that were fighting and flying the airplanes, the airmen, they were trying to get in and get some of the fighting. But they always were left behind. They didn't want to put them on the front. And Cuba Gooding, his role, he was one of the top guys that was instrumental in getting them out front. And Terrence Howard, he was talking to the big dogs and getting them up front too. And also, and the men that starred in this is Nate Parker, David Oyelowo, Elijah Kelly, and they also had Neo. Interesting mm-hmm. to see him in a movie like this.
Yeah, it was.
And it was a very good movie. The wonderful thing about this movie is the people behind making the movie didn't want to let it come out. They had to get George Lucas. He came out and helped produce and funded this movie. And that's great to have like that do it. Yeah.
It was. You don't find a one person in Hollywood, so to speak, that invest their own money into a movie totally because other backers would not back him. And so, but the movie was rated action, adventure, rated PG, so everybody could go see the one where you can take the kids and this type of thing. And this is a little bit about our history, which I think was very well demonstrated on the screen.
And these airmen, they were so great because they had maneuvers on the airborne missions that were outstanding. And when they got their chance, they really did shine. They showed how to protect the bombers. They had to take the bombers to a certain point. Mm-hmm. And the other people, I guess the so-called the whites that were escorting them would always leave when they saw danger, and they like, we ain't gonna escort you all the way. But the blacks, when they got a chance, they really proved that they were worthy, and they shot down the opposers and showed why they should always be there.
And the reason you need to look at this movie and see this movie is because this took place in Italy in 1944 during World War II. And we didn't really, a lot of people didn't know about the Tuskegee Airmen's role in World War II. They knew about them and where the school is located, but they didn't know that these fighter pilots were a totally black unit, and they had some old planes, and they finally got upgraded because their mission got upgraded, and I was glad to see that.
And they wanted to be distinguished, so they put the red tails on the back, and just so the people know, hey, this is us. And one of the courageous men, just so he could escort that bomber in, he risked his life and died, but he took him out and got him to the next point. And it's an awesome movie to see.
It definitely is.
To see us at that particular point, we weren't allowed to help. And a lot of racism was going on at that particular time, and they wouldn't let us go that far to do such a pivotal role. And they showed why they should always be on the front line. And it's an awesome movie. If you want to see some historical men that stood their ground and to bring us this far, this is a must-see movie. And I jotted down some information about some of the real first men that really were the Tuskegee Airmen that first were captains and things like that. A guy named Benjamin O. Davis, Second Lieutenant Lemuel R. Curtis, and Second Lieutenant George S. Roberts, and Second Lieutenant Mac Ross, and Second Lieutenant Charles DeBow. These were actual first time to really be ranked and first captain that really did great justice back in 1944.
And these were fighter pilots, mind you. Now, these are not cargo guys flying cargo rubber ducks out of China somewhere. They weren't airline pilots. They were fighter pilots, top of the line. And they were not given a chance until later on when the white fighter pilots just would not guard the bombers going into Berlin. So they were asked to do the job. They did the job very successfully. Of course, they lost a few guys. And that's normal in normal attrition during a war. But the majority of them survived and came back and to tell their story. And we honor them during Black History Month, which is this month.
And one of the best parts in the movie is, to me, it was the hot shot. It was a guy that played by the guy David O'Yee.
Lightning.
He was an awesome pilot, and he had just got married, and his wife was waiting for him to come home. But he did some maneuvers on that plane that nobody could touch, and he was a real killer. He was awesome.
Yeah, he was ace in that fighter group. And on the other side, there was another ace, and of course, they took each other out on the last mission, which I hated to see it go that way, but that's the way it goes in wars.
But as far as rating this movie, I have to give this an A+. And definitely, if you hadn't seen it, don't go buying the bootleg copies. Go see this movie, support this. This is for us. And for this man, George Lucas, To do this much, we should at least go support him and go actually watch the movie. Even if you know how to get a bootleg, don't buy the bootleg. Don't support them. Support the movie. Yeah. Make make the box office look good.
I know we're busy. This is a busy society we run here and there. We don't have time to do this or that. But if you don't see that in the movies, when it comes out on DVD, rent it. Just make sure you see it, period.
Only bad thing I must say, and I just get tired of these certain actors always getting the great roles, Terrence Howard and Cuba Gooding, even though they did a good role. But they should let other people unknown step up sometime. That's all I got to say. But I rate the movie A. You rated it an A?
A.
Awesome movie. Go check it out. And that's all the time we have. We'll see you next week.
All the kids make a lot of sense. So turn your TV on. It's the Herbert Dennard, Herbert Dennard Show. It's the Herbert Dennard, Herbert Dennard Show.